Hello and welcome to this video by Nerdy Electronics. In this video, we'll discuss about how to use transistor as a switch. We'll discuss both the scenarios of NPN transistor and PNP transistor and how we can use them for active high and active low cases. The simulations that you see in this video are done by Narayan. Let us first look at the symbols for NPN and PNP transistor. On the left side here, we have the PNP transistor. You can differentiate based on the direction of the arrow. For PNP transistor, the direction of the arrow is inwards from the emitter towards the base. Whereas in NPN, it is outwards from the base towards the emitter. Let us first take the case of NPN transistor and we'll see the active high case. What we mean by active high case is the load will get power only when we give a high signal into the base. Let's see this. So here we have the circuit. Let me walk you through what the circuit is. We have the supply here, which is 5 volts. This may not be a power supply, it could be a GPIO from a microcontroller also. So you can give from the microcontroller high or low. We have a switch here for simulation that goes to the base of the transistor. The emitter is grounded. And at the collector, we have a relay. This pin is the common pin, the normally closed and the normally open pin. And we have a AC supply. The power from the relay goes to two loads, the lamp and the fan. And here across the relay, we have the freewheel diode. We should always put freewheel diode with inductive loads to protect the circuit from reverse EMF, which is generated when power is cut off to the inductive load. So let's see what happens when we run this simulation. Let's see at this point. Now when the simulation has started, you can see in the voltmeters that the voltage at this point is 5 volts, which is nothing but the supply to this particular pin, that is the collector pin of the transistor. Now as soon as we switch the close the switch, you see this value drops to 0.05 volts. So what this 0.05 volts signify? This is the voltage across the transistor from between this point and this point. That is the voltage drop across the transistor. And you can see the relay is getting switched on because now this point is at 0.05 volts and this point is at 5 volts. So there is flow of current through this path that energizes the coil and the relay is activated. Once the relay is activated, the loads start getting power. So when we open the switch, when the switch is closed, it's 0.05 volts, and when we open the switch, it is 5 volts. So instead of this supply, if you have a microcontroller through a GPIO, if you give a high signal here, the switch is closed means that the positive voltage is going here. So if you have a high signal, the load will be activated. And if you have a low signal, the load will be deactivated. Let us now look how we can use NPN transistor for active low. That is, when we want to switch the load by giving a low signal at the base. So this is the circuit that I have here. Here again we have the same arrangement. It's just that in this arrangement I don't have the voltmeter. But if we look at the circuit, we have the 5 volt supply here, which is coming here. So by default, this pin is at 5 volts. This is going to the relay and the other pin is connected to the ground of the circuit. So now when there is no power into the base, this pin will be at 5 volts and 5 volts, here there is 0 volts, there will be a completion of circuit, power will flow through this, the relay will get activated and the loads will switch on. But as soon as we give 5 volts or we close the switch, the base will be activated. This will act as a short circuit. So once this acts as a short circuit, the voltage here will drop. there won't be enough voltage to drive the coil and this will not switch on. Let's see this. So now as soon as we have opened the switch, the loads are switching on here. And when the switch is closed, the loads switch off. So similar to the previous case, we can instead of the battery, we can use a GPIO from a microcontroller. But the previous case was active high. In the previous case, the relay was connected in series with the transistor. Here, it is connected in parallel with the transistor. So whenever we activate the transistor, this accelerator is short and the power stops flowing from this part. But when it is in series, whenever we activate the transistor, it starts flowing through it. You can see in this case, the relay is connected in series with the transistor. So when there is no supply to the base, the transistor acts as an open circuit. There is no continuity and hence there is no flow of current. But as soon as we close the switch, the transistor acts as a short and there is continuous flow of current which activates the relay and hence the load. Here the load gets activated when we give high input into the base. So this is active high. Whereas in this case, if we give high into the base of the transistor, the load is deactivated. But when we remove the high input, we give it a low, then the transistor is switched off and the power flows from the circuit and the load is on. So this is active low. To activate the load, we have to give a low input to the base. Let us now look at the case of PNP transistor and the active low case. This is the symbol of a PNP transistor where the arrow from the emitter goes towards the base. In this circuit, I have the same arrangement. Just the difference is that here we have a PNP transistor instead of NPN and the voltage is reversed. Earlier we had positive at the top and positive going into the base of the NPN transistor. Here we have the negative of the supply going to the NPN transistor. So earlier in NPN case, when we were closing the switch, there was a high signal going into the base, but now when we close the switch, there will be a low signal going into the base. Again, we have the relay, the freewheel diode, the supply and the loads. So we want to power the loads with this supply and we will use transistor as a switch here. So now if you see, the voltage here is 5 volts. That is because the transistor is off. It acts as an open circuit and there is no flow of current, so it shows this voltage itself. But as soon as the transistor is switched on, this will act as a short circuit and this voltage should drop to close to zero. So now when the switch is closed, we have a low signal going into the base and the transistor is switched on. When the transistor is switched on, it acts as a short and the voltage drops to 0 volts. So now the relay is activated and the loads are powered. Now when we remove the switch, that is when we open the switch, the transistor will switch off and the voltage at this junction will go back to 5 volts. You see, as soon as we open the switch, the voltage went back to 5 volts. The transistor got switched off. So whenever we want to switch a PNP transistor, we have to give a low voltage at the base. Now similarly, there can be an active high case also, but we won't discuss this in the video. There can be many other arrangements, like instead of having the load in serial, you can have it in parallel. NPN transistor or PNP transistor. The load connected in series or in parallel. The load is connected at the emitter or at the collector. All these different arrangements you can see in the article, the link of which I have mentioned in the description. Thank you.